get loose and produce. Oh baby, how you doing today?
All right, what's up everybody? So before we start making crazy sounds, we gotta make sure that we got our fundamentals down. And I see way too many professional producers make these mistakes. So number one, you gotta mono your low end. Unless you're Lorne or you're making some crazy super hectic ambient film score, just do it. It's easy. You can do it in many different ways and it's gonna make your mix way tighter. Trust. So here we have this basic reese. And you best believe my fucking low end is mono. Because this is a leading sound, this is in the drop. Mono eliminates any of those kind of weird movements that it may have and is just giving you that pure body and depth that you need in your low end. There's many ways to do this. You can parallel process it, or you can just throw like a stereo tools on and zero below a certain frequency. So I would recommend monoing everything below 130, 180. All right, tip number two, send your damn reverbs. Especially on vocals, you gotta send it. Unless you're creating some epic textures or you're adding some depth to your basses during sound design, I don't wanna see reverb on your vocal channel. I see too many people do this. Bring their mix down and they think that's all good. That's not all good. You can't do that. Don't do that on your vocal especially. Let's look at an example. This is the vocal dry.
I've been trying to think about you, but I don't remember much.
Here's the vocal with the reverb on it.
I've been trying to think about you, but I don't remember much.
Here's the same vocal with the scrub way of doing your reverb.
I've been trying to think about you, but I don't remember much. We made all these promises. I remember some, but not enough.
You hear the difference? There's so much more room cut out in the middle for the vocal to come through, especially in the mix. Is gonna sound much better. I got a bonus tip for you. If you're sending your vocal reverbs, just filter out the low end. You don't need any of that information anyway to be coming through in your reverbs. It's gonna make things more muddy. Cut your high end as well, because if you don't cut your high end, you're gonna get this.
I've been trying to think about you.
So by keeping the high end, you're gonna get those like little textures that sit on top, and then the reverb is gonna accentuate them, and you don't want that. You want your tops to be filled in with some percussion or some other elements of the track. Tip number three, you gotta sidechain your basses with your kicks and your claps and your drums, because you want the drums to be the leading tempo element. And usually kick drums, they have bass on their own. They don't need to be muffled up with your bass sound. They're just gonna overlap and sound disgusting. So all you do is just you take your kick, you sidechain it to a channel where your sub is on or your bass is on, and then you just sidechain it. So listen to the difference. So much tighter.
That's how I like it.
All right, that was it. Real quick tips. Put them in your mix right now. It's gonna sound much better. Thanks for listening. If you have any questions, leave it in the comments or whatever. And let us know what other you guys want us to cover. Peace out.